Welcome back to another programming tutorial in Game Dev Club. So last time we talked about numerical variables, but there are also other types of variables. And one of those other types is called a Boolean. A Boolean is a statement that represents true or false. So let's see how these work. So why don't you go ahead and make a new Java project. You're gonna name it Booleans. Alright, so you're going to go into the source, make a new class, just like last time. It's going to be called Boolean example. Yeah, just Boolean example. Alright. I forgot to, okay, whatever. Public static void main string. Want this class to be able to run, so we put our main method. Alright, so to declare a Boolean, you just simply type Boolean, B-O-O-L-E-A-N. Boolean, and like all variables, it needs a name, Boolean bool2. Alright, bool1 is equal to true, bool2 is equal to false. You can see true and false are keywords, so you can't name variables true or false, you need to have them be something else. So, yeah, println bool1. Alright, system.out println bool2. Alright, so we run it. True, false. It's simple, just on that. So Booleans aren't usually explicitly assigned true or false. They're often expressed in statements. The statements are greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, or not equal to. So let's these are all called Boolean operators. So let's show you these operators. So we're gonna make a new class. We're gonna call it Boolean operators. I forgot to do it again. I'm actually going to delete this. Yes. I want to show you something cool that Eclipse can do. Put in a new class. You can just simply do this, and it'll put in your public static void main string args. Just, yeah. Just like that. Alright, so we're going to make... So, our Boolean operators are greater than is going to be all errors, less than, greater than or equal to, what did I just do? I'm going to control 7 that. Right now, less than or equal to equal to and not equal to. Remember this exclamation point. That exclamation point pretty much just means not, but there's just this operator that's not equal to, but not is also used in Boolean. So yeah, now let's put this to use. Let's make an integer x and an integer y. We're gonna set x to 5 and y to 3. Now we're gonna make booleans for all of these. So we're gonna make one greater, boolean less, boolean greater than or equal to, boolean less than equal to, boolean equal, boolean not equal. Oops. All right. So greater is equal to x is greater than y. Less is equal to x is less than y. greater or equal to x is greater than or equal to y. Less than or equal to is equal to x is less than or equal to y. Please make sure you take note of the syntax right here. It's variable space operator space. Variable space operator space, variable space operator space. That's just another one of those clean code rules. Equal, not equal. Equal to x is not equal to y. All right, now let's just print these all out. So system.out println greater. I can type, don't worry. Ugh, stupid typos. Here we go. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. I might have gone over one. Yeah, I went over one. Alright. Alright, cool. So that's that. So let's just run this. Save it. So you should get true, false, true, false, false, true. Because, so let's look at that. So our first statement is greater. X is greater than Y. 5 is greater than 3. True. Our next one is less. 5 is less than 3. That's false. Greater than or equal to. 5 is greater than or equal to 3. So that's also true. Less than or equal to. That's 5 is less than or equal to 3. That's false. And then our next is equal to. 5 is equal to 3. That is false. And 5 is not equal to 3. That is true. There are more operators. There's the AND and there's the OR operator. These mean that basically you put in two Booleans and it checks if both Booleans or just one Boolean are true. So let's just make our new class. I'll explain them. I'll explain exactly what they mean in a second. So we're gonna make this AND OR operators. All right, cool. So Control 7. AND is expressed like this, and it means both given Booleans are true. Now this returns true if both given Booleans are true. And then we have our OR operator, OR double bar, it's the shift backward slash, or yeah, just slash, if you want to find that, and to do the ampersand double is shift 7. So returns true if, should be all, because you can give more than two, if at least one given Boolean is true. Alright, so now let's take a look at this. So let's think Boolean bool1 and Boolean bool2. We're gonna make another Boolean and Boolean OR. So I'm gonna do bool1 is equal to true and bool2 is equal to false. And is equal to bool1 and bool2, or is equal to bool1 or bool2. So then we're gonna do sit. Now we're gonna print those, and and we should be getting false true, because in an AND statement, if you give two Booleans, it makes sure that both of these Booleans are true. So it goes to bool1, it checks it, it's true. It goes to bool2, checks it, it's false. So then AND is false. But with an OR statement, it goes to true, false, but if one of them is true, it pretty much just ignores the rest of it. So yeah, it just pretty much checks if all of these or statements are used pretty much if you have like different keys for like different controls, like in gaming. And that's basically that. The last operator is the not operator. The not operator, as I said, is an exclamation point. Pretty much just means not, so. Oh, I forgot to, okay, whatever. I'm just gonna copy and paste. Copy and paste is your friend. Not, exclamation point, returns the opposite of the given Boolean. All right, so Boolean, oops, bool one, Boolean, bool two. Bool one is equal to true. Oops, I can type. Bool two is equal to false, or no, equal to not bool one. All right, which actually would be false. So system.out.println. Bool 2. I get false. So this is basically all I have to say on just Booleans. There's a whole bunch more on how Booleans are used. This is just the syntax of how Booleans work, what makes them true, what makes them false. And yeah, so we have our just our normal Booleans, true, false. We have our operators, which are greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, not equal to. We have our and or operators, and we have our not operator. These are all operators that you will be using, so it's best that you remember all of this. And if not, you can always come back to this video and relearn it. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. And yeah.